Behold, the ugliest Vic ever. We're gonna try and fix this mostly within the span of 15 minutes. Quick walk. And icky Vicky. Okay, I lied. 45 minutes later. Still. Not bad for a very quick change out with me rushing and everything lines up right. Nice.
Well, hello YouTube land. I'm back finally with another car, and again, it's my old favorite, the Crown Vic. This one's nickname, Icky Vicky. Now, you're wondering why she's called Icky Vicky? Well, I got bored and started working on her. I was gonna record video, but file got started to get corrupted, gave up. And yeah, just went to town on her.
This is an 05 LX, not the LX Sport. Still very nice. She is rocking 16s in the front and 17s in the back. Yeah, that's weird. What have I done so far to her? Well, had to replace this first and foremost. You can tell by the spotty paint job by spray painting the roof because it was bad. The hood's been replaced by a police interceptor model. The trunk's been replaced by a police interceptor model. She is a started off in Florida as a rental car. Don't mind the tag, it's my neighbor's. I borrowed it off the Tahoe when I traded that one off because he traded back to me with a blown transmission. She is rocking the wrong lug nuts. Mostly. Again, her paint is not the best. I just had some keys bought for her, but I can't find a cutter yet. But I got the remote programmed. There's the other spare. Well, yeah, the other original is in the front, but as you can see, no. Just no. We have a tire cover, which I will actually put that to use because I don't want like seeing that metal. And if you can tell by the bulge, she didn't like driving on this either. Good enough. Oh yeah, I got to do a video on this guy later. Got that in a trade. Got some wheel covers, which are just 16s and 17s. Might not even use them, not sure yet. Everything's debatable. Now, when I first got her, her interior was filthy. But once again, I am in a rush to do things. And yeah. Also, you notice that the seats are a little bulged out here. The prior owner tried to put an amp in here. Didn't know about two bolts holding the seat in. And bent the shit out of the frame. Kind of a good shape. Notice the tree over there. She was smoked in, so she has a heavy smell of smoke. The lock does work. I'll bring it down the four later on to figure out the code. So yeah, paint job. Actually, on the camera doesn't look that bad, but still not the best. And it works. It's better than the rust. But yeah, most of that was done within about 30 minutes. She has a 138k miles on her. This doesn't work. I'll work on that later. It's probably a blown resistor. Another tree. Stepping on clips over here. Lumbar support, all electric seats. She is rough idling. So I have new spark plugs. That's another blank. There's the key. Aftermarket radio. I don't think the AC works right now. We do have a flashing airbag light that will go, yeah, there it is. We have an EGR valve leak. I reset the codes in the engine trying to see if it would change anything out. Sadly, no. No owner's manual. Got a nickel. Philip! PowerPoint, ooh, yeah, you can hear her. I think there's a hole in the exhaust. She definitely has a hole in the exhaust. Oh. Okay. Interesting. Oh, that rear diff is leaking like a sieve. Work on that later.
Definitely the hole in the exhaust. She has a miss. Yeah, she's dripping from the rear diff. I gotta look in on that. Ooh. Her exhaust is rubbing into the plastic right there. That's not good. Huh. She did have decals like the Icky Vicky you saw on top, which I don't like. That miss is bad. Old Navajo here. Now I have a Moby Dick over here. Got some work done too, which I'm not gonna go into right now. Let me know when you see what I did. I'm not sure where I put those spark plugs for her. Oh well. Oh yeah, junkyard tire. She has a hole this side too. Sure as shit she does. More on that later. She's definitely gonna need a little help. Alright, and the bright side's clear, so we now, at least now we know that it's not burning oil. There's no leak from the radiator. I didn't see any blowback earlier. Gotta replace this later. Driver passenger window doesn't work. Front passenger, let's call that front passenger. I can tell someone's been here before because that bolt on the damn alternator is loose. Air cleaner was fresh. Let me check the blow-by. I forgot to check this when I traded, but... oily. But yeah, she runs pretty solid though, even though I can tell she has a little bit of mist there. I got more of these. When I pulled off the hood. Oh yeah, gotta find a new grill for her too. If you want to see how bad the hood and trunk was, go over here and take a look. Can't go far, my daughter's taking a nap inside, so I'm not leaving the house. Early. Alright, we'll park her over there in a minute. After we take off Icky Vicky. Okay, here's the old trunk. I peeled off the Ford badge. No paint. Here's the original hood. My tree. No paint and rust. So yeah. Interesting. There's the police badge right there. Huh, her exhaust is getting a little better. But yeah, all the seats work. I'm probably gonna try and pull a dual exhaust from one of the wrecked police fix. Give her a good chance at life. Again, the weird thing with these 05, 06 models, they got actual antennas. Give her a little gas, try and see if she shoots out any fluids. Automatic headlights. Let's see what brand is this. I think it's a JVC Air the brand. Oof. Definitely got a nasty little exhaust leak or something that I miss. Yeah, she's not happy with that one.
All right, girl, all right. Yeah. But yeah, that's kind of where we're at now. I'm gonna grab my scraper, which I misplaced again. God damn it. And then we'll go from there. I gotta find my scraper now. Either way,
Icky Vicky is no longer as icky as she was when I got her.
But she is still a rough rider. So, you know what?
Icky Vicky the rough rider. I like it. Have a good one, you guys.